Do you want to achieve success faster and greater? Hi, I'm Dr. Chris Zaino with 5 Minute Fuel, which is in 5 minutes a day, we're going to fuel your mind, your body, and your future. Going through characteristic traits of the greatest champions, heroes, or movers and shakers of history, the way they became successful very quickly is they believed in thought leadership or the mastermind principle, the true mastermind. Hold, don't switch me off, because that term mastermind is being mutilated into today's society. What you hear as mastermind is not what the mastermind. Stay with me and I'll tell you exactly what a true mastermind is. Thought leadership is the key. See, when you're moving forward, you get an idea, an inspired idea. You all have ideas, great ideas, billion-dollar ideas to change the world. You get the idea, then what do? You think of all the fears and the fogs and the reasons why you can't do it. Well, I don't have the capital, I don't know how to do the internet stuff, I don't know how to run this ad, I have no, you know, like you start to think of the fears and the fogs, the things that you're, like, instead of sticking to your vision and what it could do for the world, for yourself, for your family, for your friends, for everybody else, you go start focusing on things that you can't do. So how do we destroy the fears and fogs? It's thought leadership. It's thought leadership. It means that you go and you seek out other superheroes where they are experts, or they don't even have to be a master. They could just be, you know, more knowledgeable and have a lot better wisdom in those areas that you have no wisdom in. So you're taking other people, you're teaming up with other people that have years of experience, ups, downs, contrast in life. They learned the hard way, probably invested a lot of money in learning, right, through hard knocks. And now they're at somewhat level of success or proficiency. So you meet them, and instead of saying, I'm going to learn it, I'm going to go on Google and figure it out, you find other people, you team up with other people, you have thought leadership, people, counselors around you, you seek wisdom, and you shorten the learning curve and you shorten the time. And if you could shorten the time and the learning curve for your goal and vision, then it creates momentum. See, the longer, what happens, the longer that learning curve is, what's going to happen? Procrastination. You lose momentum. You start letting that fear, that insecurity, those fears in the fogs sneak in. You let that secret identity come in and say, listen, come on, you got it good. You know, you're doing okay. It's not great, but it's good, right? You're not suffering. So just stay here. Be comfortable. Don't worry about it. That will kill you. That's mediocrity. So that true hero arises. And then you have those fears and fogs because it's exposing those areas that you need to fulfill this vision and goal. And you go out and you seek those people to do it. And as you, and you go through your journey, you might have someone says, yeah, I know how to do that. And they suck and they don't. That's okay. Doesn't mean you quit. No, you find somebody else and you build this team around you. Some of the greatest leaders, such as Andrew Carnegie, Henry Ford, this principle is amazing. Henry Ford really wasn't educated at all. It has nothing to do about education. But he says, listen, I'm not educated, but I definitely know the people I could call to answer any question I need about what I do. Right? So Henry Ford, he had a mastermind with his buddy Firestone Tires, right? And then Andrew Carnegie did steel. So they all work together in what we call thought leadership or the mastermind principle, which I'll talk about now, to be able to get the job done. So they became, back in the time, they were equivalent of hundreds of billionaires. You know, we think of a Jeff Bezos today, richest man alive, but they were up there, if not equivalent, the same, because they had people. They didn't do it all themselves. They had people in their categories who knew their job and their profession well enough to team up, and then together, they went faster, further, and bigger than they ever dreamed imaginable. So the mastermind principle is this. The mastermind principle means that you have 2, 3, 4, maybe up to 5 or 6 people that all play a certain role in different areas of your life, and their intention is to help you, and their purpose is to help you get what you want. And your intention is to help them get what they want. See, most masterminds today are networking events, and you need networking for sure. But that's separate. A mastermind is having a group of people that you could trust, it's safe, and you know their intention is not, what can I get from you? Their intention is, listen, we're going to come together for harmony. Together, we're going to work in harmony. Just think of the car. Firestone did the tires. Carnegie did the steel. Ford had the vision. You know, like, you have, everybody came together in harmony, and only beautiful things that affect and increase life for all of us in the world is a result of that. So that's a true mastermind. It's not networking, that's different. A mastermind is, you know, if you could find those two, three people that you could share ideas, be in a safe place, and you know that they look out for the best of you and you only want the best for them, that's when amazing thing happens. So thought leadership is the key to reaching success faster and bigger than ever possible. Have an amazing day. Thanks for watching 5 Minute Fuel. Check us out on social media, Instagram, Facebook, YouTube, at Dr. Zaino. Go to IAmHero.com for some of the great stuff we have for you guys, and I will see you soon.